The content of Kingdom of Healing with Kimberly Mateo, powered by 710 Radio, is intended for general information purposes only. It is not designed to provide listeners with specific and personal medical, financial, legal, counseling, professional services, or any advice. The programs are not meant to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease. Individuals with health problems should always consult their health care provider for professional medical advice, medications, and/or treatments. Kingdom of Healing also does not promote anyone's individual practices, programs, agendas, particular treatments, health care programs, providers, hospitals, and or medical centers. The views expressed by show host and their guests are their own and shall not be construed in any way as advice from Kingdom of Healing. We make no recommendations or endorsements for radio show programs, services, or products mentioned on air or on our website. Personal perspectives expressed by the producers, writers, or editors will always be presented as such. We encourage you to always seek professional advice or care for any problems which you may have. No liability, explicit or implied, shall be extended to the Kingdom of Healing or 710 Radio or the show host whose words and or opinions appear from or on this radio show.
People drive by, T-Mac on the radio. Got so much on your mind, nothing's really going right. Looking for a ray of hope.
Hi, welcome for joining me today on Kingdom of Healing. This is Kimberly Mateo. I'm a traditional naturopath and a master herbalist, and I've been in the field for about 38 years now. So I hope that what I share with you today and through all of my shows helps you and your loved ones to overcome any health challenges that you might be dealing with. Today I kind of want to talk about it's summertime, and in a lot of parts of the country and the world, you are consistently getting sun. It's pretty intermittent here in Colorado between a little bit of sun and lots of rain, which is unusual for us. But with a lot of the sunburns and stuff and the damage that takes place to the skin now, especially with the children, you know, those bad sunburns are what affect you in 20, 30, 40 years as far as, you know, diagnoses with different types of skin cancer. So it's really, really important to make sure that the skin is protected, and that when you, you know, do suffer a really bad burn, that you are able to take care of that immediately with something from an antioxidant standpoint that can help safeguard against the damage to the skin. So, you know, I've talked about in past shows, there was a show last summer where I went through, last June, where I went through salves that you can make and ointments for, you know, sunburns and keeping bugs and stuff away, especially the mosquitoes. And you could refer back to, you know, one of those shows. There's a lot of information there that I won't have time to go through today. But, you know, a good quick sunscreen is you can take the fractionated coconut oil and add to that, just take about 4 ounces of fractionated coconut oil or shea butter and a little bit of beeswax. Melt that down in a double boiler. And to say 4 ounces, say, of shea butter, for instance, or coconut butter. Coconut butter or coca butter. You can melt that down. Melt also down to 4 ounces. Melt down 1 ounce of beeswax. And, you know, blend that together real well. And then to that, you can add 1 teaspoon of a zinc oxide and make yourself a real quick sunscreen. If you want to add some essential oils to that, lemongrass is excellent to help repel bugs, mosquitoes, flies, keep them away. Add a little peppermint to that. Or if you go to, you know, if you go to kingdomofhealing.com and type that in the search bar, you'll be able to find the lemongrass and be able to purchase that. The there's another product called Terra Shield, T-E-R-R-A, Shield. And you can find that on Herbal Medicine Doctor, and it's herbalmedicinedr.com. And at that site, you're able to order the Terra Shield, which has lemongrass and citronella and menthol and a lot of things that flies and spiders and mosquitoes and ticks do not like. They do not like that smell, and it repels them. And that is certainly something that you want to be able to, you know, one teaspoon, 5 milligrams of your oils equals 20 drops. And then you can add that into 3 tablespoons of shea butter or coconut oil or fractionated coconut oil and put that directly on the skin. So you can also add that a teaspoon of the Terra Shield to a spray bottle with a little bit of fractionated coconut oil in that. You just put like a teaspoon. And in an 8-ounce bottle, fill that with water and put a teaspoon of the fractionated coconut oil and a teaspoon of the Terra Shield and keep shaking that up. And you can apply that to, if you're walking around in the woods and stuff, you can just spray that on the body, mist that on the body, and be sure to get that around the shoes and tuck your pants down into your shoes if you're out in the woods where got a lot of ticks and stuff. But I would, you know, just spray that real well all over you and on your shoes, and you'll be good by repelling those ticks. So one thing I want to talk about is aloe vera. And at kingdomofhealing.com, in that upper right page under the search bar, you can find the aloe vera gel. And they also carry not only an aloe vera juice, but they have a concentrated aloe vera juice. And that concentrated aloe is 10 times the strength of the regular aloe vera juice.
Wow.
So every time you take 1 ounce of that internally, it's like taking 10 ounces of aloe vera juice. So it's really, the concentrate is a far better buy. And the aloe vera gel, you know, that's excellent to have on hand for burns and skin problems. And, you know, aloe vera gel, this particular formula, the transdermally by putting it on the skin, that's absorbed. And all those good properties are absorbed into the skin, and it makes it as well into the bloodstream within 3 minutes. So aloe, you know, has been used for ages for all of its healing properties. So it's something that's historically is really well documented. And there is a lot of research, and PubMed.org has a lot of published research on far more, you know, herbal products and herbs than you would realize that they have. So, again, when your medical doctor tells you that herbs are unproven and there's no scientific research, They need to check out PubMed because there's hundreds of thousands of published research studies on a variety of different things in the herb kingdom. So one of the things, if you're going to use aloe vera from, say, maybe you have a plant, you want to make sure that that plant is 4 years old or older. If you're going to slice, break off part of that leaf and slice it and use that directly on the skin, you want to make sure that that plant is 4 years old or older. So aloe vera has been used for, you know, as far back as, you know, they started documenting things, aloe's been around. And it's known for its healing properties. And what it has the ability to do is it will, you know, it can dilate the capillaries, and which improves the blood flow to the areas where it's being applied. Aloe contains enzymes which break down dead tissue. So it also is very saturated with a lot of nutrients which promote healthy cell proliferation to accelerate healing of burns and wounds. So a lot of the studies that have been done on aloe show that it does help to speed the healing process. It does help to heal first and second degree burns, and it also inhibits bacteria from entering a wound. So aloe increases the healing of radiation burns. And one thing is the aloe vera gel has in it elgin. And I've talked about elgin before from a radiation standpoint. Right. And we sell single elgin. And elgin also helps as a thickener. So it's the natural thickening agent in this aloe vera gel. You know, it's not filled with a bunch of typical garbage that you see and stuff. And I think what cracks me up is, you know, you realize that you're all out of aloe vera and you go run into a store and everybody wants to make their aloe vera green. And you look on the back of the label and, you know, aloe's somewhere down there in the line, you know, in the lineup of the ingredients. And then down at the bottom, you know, you see the yellow dye and the blue dye and to make the green color. And it's just really gross. So why would you want to take your skin that either has an abrasion or a cut or a sunburn or a severe sunburn or a severe burn and put something like that has the food dyes in it and some of the other things like the glycol, polyethylene glycol in right. it, you know, it's like, yeah, I don't think so.
No, there's no reason.
You know, there's really no reason for it. And of course, it'll have on the label that it's natural. You know,
right.
It's natural, and we've trashed it. It's natural and trashed. So our aloe vera gel that you find on kingdomofhealing.com, it's clear. So I just want you to know that when you go to use that and it's not green, that's because there's no toxins that are put into that. So, but the elgin, like I said, I've talked about that in past shows. It's one way to pull radiation out of the body.
Wow.
So, you know, radiation treatments, if you're going through those, it's really good to be on whole leaf aloe vera internally, as well as 2 to 3 capsules twice a day of just the elgin.
Okay.
If you're undergoing that helps to pull that radiation out of the body.
I have to remember that one.
Yeah, elgin, ALGIN, and it's under the single herbs. So the Japan is who made the discovery initially on the elgin, and they used it for radiation burns that were suffered by the Japanese survivors of the atomic bomb. More than any other type of burn treatment, according to verified claims, you know, the aloe is what worked the best, as well as taking internally the Elgin. So studies have been conducted by the University of Pennsylvania, and that was all the way back in the, I say all the way back, in the 60s.
To some people, that's old.
And, you know, as we get older, we realize that, you know, we thought people were really old at that age when we were little, but, you know, here we are, and it's like, well, I don't feel that old.
Right.
I don't feel that old at all, and I don't think I look like they did. You know, but, well, other people's grandmas and great-grandmas and great-great-grandmas, because I had my great-great-grandmother till 1967.
Wow.
Yeah, so that was really cool to have her that long. She was a cool gal. In the 60s, the University of Pennsylvania did some studies, and it showed aloe vera to be the most effective treatment for minor radiation burns. The research showed that the skin cells destroyed by the burns release a substance known as thromboxanes, and which prevent the healing of surrounding cells also injured. Aloe vera has been used to inhibit the release of thromboxanes, as well as reduce formation of scar tissue by enhancing the new cell proliferation. So then there is recent studies that show that aloe vera indicates that it has properties that have antifungal action against Candida albicans. Another study reports that aloe relieves the irritation and the inflammation from poison ivy. So I know something down south, there's plenty of that. When I had my log house, I'd always wanted a house that had ivy that grew on the house. Yeah, well, I guess we got an ivy was growing up the east side of my log house. It was poison ivy. Yeah, so, yeah, that wasn't good. Well, you know, ha-ha. Cut all that stuff down. Burn it. So, since down there, everything grows. So it's something to have on hand in the event that you get into some poison ivy. If you apply it topically, aloe helps with abrasions and burns, cuts, you know, diaper rash. Another thing that works really well with the diaper rash is we have the Silver Shield ointment, and it has the nano silver in it. And with the aloe vera gel being beneficial for candida, you add the aloe. You know, just mix a little bit of the aloe and the silver gel and put that on diaper rash areas and for cradle cap. Cradle cap.
Give me a second to...
Yeah, aloe vera and the silver gel, because a lot of that cradle cap is candida. It's yeast. And a lot of times, you know, these scalded bottoms anymore, that's so common with the little ones. I really think it has to do with, my gosh, we have these diapers that'll hold a gallon.
Right, right.
You know, whoa. And diapers left on too long because they're expensive, and the diapers pull away, you know, and try to keep the skin drier, but it's still moist. It's you know, if that diaper's on too long, I know moms don't let their kids run around with a gallon worth in their diaper, but you know,
it can't be good for your skin.
It's just not good for your skin. And then they use all these diaper wipes.
Right.
I mean, it's crazy to me, because, I mean, talk about some more pollution from the landfills, as if it's not bad enough with all the diapers, but then you have the diaper wipes. And, you know, what's going to be biodegradable quicker is a paper towel, you know, and you just make up a solution with, you know, a little acid water and acidic water that's good for the skin, or just some purified water, and put a little teaspoon or so in of some baking soda into that. Clean the area with that, or soap and water if you need to, and then baking soda and water. You know, these little bottoms that are just so red and irritated, and then they have raised areas and stuff on the skin. And, you know, it looks like candida, and it responds really well and heals up with using the aloe vera gel and that silver gel together. It works immediately. So, you know, apply topically. Diaper rash is another one, eczema, insect bites and stings, irritations, eczema, psoriasis, scratches, skin rashes, skin ulcers, sunburn, wounds. We also have a special nano silver product that is for specifically for wound dressings. So that one is to be used with deep punctures and things that are deep that need to be healed. So aloe also works best when it's used either alone or with one or two products. In some cases, golden seal can be mixed with aloe and applied to fight an infection that is in a cut or minor wound. So if you've got something where you've got an infection, there's an awful lot of MRSA these days. And I've seen what aloe and the silver gel will do with MRSA topically on the skin. And there's a lot of tests with the nano silver, and I was trying to find that in my email. It's I'm having a hard time finding it because it goes back all the way to 2007.
Oh.
I have, like, I don't know how many thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of emails I have. But it's funny because I was thinking about it last night, and I remembered that I had forwarded that and sent it to someone. And so I just have to go back and search my emails of that person to retrieve that. So on one of the shows, I could bring that information up and share some of that, because the nano silver that is sold through kingdomofhealing.com, that Silver Shield product has been tested against its efficacy with, lined up with other big gun antibiotics.
Wow.
And it holds its own very well.
Right on. Okay.
And
that's good to know, though.
It holds its own. So, you know, this is something that as we have more and more of this resistance to all of the antibiotics that people develop, the silver is something that is amazing in how well it works. And the silver is also selective. It doesn't kill the good bacteria. It kills just the bad bacteria. So that's something that is really important, because we know as we do more antibiotics and stuff, it not only kills off the good bacteria, the bad bacteria, but it kills off the good, and, you know, can lead into what I had talked about on a past show with leaky gut, and that is some serious stuff. Aloe vera has been shown to speed healing following dermabrasion. And there have been, you know, there's been some reports that some people haven't handled that real well. I had a friend who had that laser peel done, where they went four layers and burnt off four layers of your skin.
Wow.
She had her upper eyelids done, and then the plastic surgeon talked her into, instead of a facelift, to do this chemical peel I took care of her face that first 5 or 6 days after that surgery. It was that procedure. She showed back up to the house after having that done, and you know, her face was lightly covered in gauze. And when she brought that gauze down, it looked like somebody took a blowtorch to her face. It was horrible.
Wow.
It was horrible. So how that was all cleaned was a little bit of vinegar in purified water, and then dabbed on the skin, because vinegar is also antibacterial.
Which vinegar?
It was just a regular
white vinegar.
No, it was distilled. We used apple cider vinegar.
Okay.
Teaspoon of apple cider vinegar into a bowl. Maybe it was a tablespoon of apple cider vinegar into about a quart bowl of purified water, and then dabbed that on the skin. And then after that was done, then a nice, heavy, thick application of half silver gel and half aloe vera gel was then globbed onto her face and to her neck. And when she went back to the doctor, for a checkup on it, he could not believe how quickly her skin had healed. And compared to all of his other patients, the time in which her skin healed was amazing. He signed up under her, and they used the silver gel and the aloe gel. And she signed up her plastic surgeon to be able to buy the product at wholesale and make it available to his patients.
Wow.
Yeah.
I mean, what is it going to do, a chemical thing on you? I mean, come on, man.
She was not aging well at all.
Oh, man.
Well, she wasn't aging well at all, so. But that was the procedure that we used to clean the skin as it healed. And, you know, and like I said, you know, the aloe vera has properties in it that those enzymes, those proteolytic enzymes that break down the dead tissue, dead skin cells, so it helps to break that down. So this particular product is the aloe vera gel is 97.75% cold stabilized and pure aloe vera pulp. Then there's 2% of algin, and that's obtained from kelp, and it's used as a thickening agent. Oriental medicine recommends topical application of algin for burns, insect bites, and various skin diseases. Then there's 0.1% of sorbic acid, and that's obtained from berries from the mountain ash, and that's used to inhibit bacteria. Ascorbic acid at 0.05% is some added vitamin C, and it's to help to promote the healing of the tissue. And it works as, the ascorbic acid works as a natural preservative. So it's a natural preservative, but then it also has a benefit. And then there is 0.05% of Irish moss. And Irish moss has a high mucilaginous properties to it. So it's like jello. It's soothing. It's cooling. It's healing. And it's a high moisturizer. So it soothes any inflamed or ulcerated surfaces. And it's really good. Irish moss is also really good for chapped skin and dermatitis. Now, you know, the properties that are found in aloe vera, there's a lot of nutritional properties in aloe. And, you know, there's over 200 nutritional substances. And another ingredient is salicylate. And that's like derived from what aspirin, salicylic acid, comes from. And that's your anti-inflammatory. It's your analgesic, which is a pain reliever. So it's like a natural aspirin compound to it. It also, the enzymes that have been shown to restrain the properties that cause tissue to become inflamed. So it's an inhibitor. Aloe soothing actions make it a valuable resource for treating various gastrointestinal complaints. So this is the concentrated aloe vera juice, or you can do the regular aloe vera juice. Like I said, the concentrated 1 ounce is equal to 10 ounces of a regular aloe vera juice. So the concentrated one, it's 32 ounces, one bottle, ounce in the morning. That it'll last you 32 days.
Wow.
Okay. So aloe has been used, you know, to treat a lot of gastrointestinal problems, including colitis, ulcerative colitis, which is Crohn's disease, diarrhea, constipation, irritable bowel syndrome. It's really important for the healing of leaky gut syndrome. And the show that I talked about, leaky gut, I mean, it's really serious stuff.
Right.
And it is something that affects far more people than the medical field would like to admit to. And it has to do with diet. You know, it is related to diet and antibiotics. So aloe goes back to the ancient Egyptians. You know, there were medical writings indicating the use of aloe for healing infections and wounds and skin problems. And Ayurvedic physicians today use aloe is really good for intestinal worms. So
really?
We've kind of talked about the parasite thing before, whether you like it or not. They can be lurking, you know. So, and if you know they're lurking, you know, there's a great product called Paracleanse.
Right, but that's always the one show that sticks in my mind.
The parasite one.
I don't like that one.
Yeah.
That's why it sticks with me.
It's amazing what. Yeah, what we can be exposed to, and I think I've mentioned this before. You know, my aunt had these hardened buildups in her lungs, and she went to see Hannah Kroger, who was a little herbalist that lived up in Boulder, and this was like 1982, and my aunt was just not doing well at all, and it was really hard to oxygenate, and she had numerous, these little, like, calcified things in her lungs, and she went to see little Hannah Kroger, and Hannah told her that she had parasites in her lungs, and asked her if she slept with any animals. And my aunt said, yeah, I have Great Danes. And I've got two of them sleep in my bed. Well, turned out these calcifications that were in my aunt's lungs were the calcification shields that these parasites were making. And she got them from her Great Danes. She took her Danes into the vet, and they were diagnosed with parasites. And it turned out to be Hannah Kroger put her on an herb program. And, you know, only under the supervision of a qualified alternative health practitioner and aromatherapist do you take wintergreen or menthol internally. You know, normally that is not something that you do, but back in 1982, Hannah Kroger had my aunt drinking oil of wintergreen. And I'm not kidding you. She started coughing and bringing all of those things up. It killed them. And she was able to to cough them up. Yeah. I know it sounds disgusting.
It does, but I mean...
But you know what? Yeah, you know, she overcame it and cleansed her lungs and got back her full breathing capacity and stuff. And she'd been to the doctors numerous times about it, and there was not anything that the medical field could do at all. And they never even died. They thought it was just calcifications.
Wow.
And there just really wasn't anything to do then about that. Well, those calcifications, those were parasites inside there. They do exist, as much as you don't want to believe it.
Right,
but
right.
There's the Paracleanse on kingdomofhealing.com. Paracleanse, type that in the search bar. And that's a product that you do. There's enough for 10 days. Get 3 boxes. You go through a package twice a day. When you're done with that, you rest 10 days. You go through another box of them. You rest another 10 days and then go through your last box of them. And you won't have any parasites that don't belong in your body when you are done with that. So it's really, really amazing.
I'm thinking about buying 3 boxes just to make sure.
Just,
I mean,
you know,
I ain't
just
got them.
To,
I don't think I did,
hey,
but man,
summer cleanse, you know, a summer cleanse. Nothing wrong with that. Now would be the good time because... You know, what's cool about right now is all the abundance of the organic produce and people having gardens and stuff like that. And hopefully you're not using 7-Dust or Roundup that has added to it now this year, you know, the 2-4, the 2-4-D.
You know, and I got to tell you a little story.
Agent Orange stuff.
You know, my wife, a funny character. You know, we have our show here. We talk about, you know, the... GMO stuff, and you know, we've talked about seeds and everything, and my daughter and my wife wanted me to grow some corn this year, right? And
non-GMO organic.
Oh well, you know, they went out and bought a couple packets of seeds, brought them home, and said, "Here you go, you know, plant these." You know, and I'm looking at them. First thing I read is disease resistant seed. You know, I mean, I'm like.
No, that's not the one.
I'm not going to.
That's not the stuff we want.
Right.
Yeah.
I would have felt almost, you know, two-faced and
yeah.
If I would have grown them.
And I'd have been a little upset if by the end of the summer you offered me a bunch of corn. It's
right.
Like, so I tricked you.
Well, you know, at least I'm paying attention now. You know,
right,
I mean,
yes.
I really am. I'm reading my labels now, you know, and I'm really...
Yeah,
I got to thank the show for it. You know, I mean, I thought I was careful before, but you know, the show really, you know, made me up my game as far as.
And there's just so much information out there. There will never be a shortage of anything to talk about. You know, because there's just so much information out there, and you know, the things with the seeds, I really, you know, like the company Seeds of Change, but there are other, you know, there's other heirloom companies out there,
right,
and
right.
You know, they do have heirloom seeds that are not hybrids, and they're not, you know, the other big tip is where it says packed for, you know, 2015 season. And then you open up that package and everything's like blue in there. It's got, what is all this blue powder stuff all over?
Right, right.
You know, so, yeah, not good. So if it says packed just for this season, you know, you don't want that. One thing about the heirloom seeds is if you don't get them planted this year and you keep them in a cool, dark spot, you can plant them next year. They'll grow. Those ones that you buy for this season, if you don't grow them this year, they will not grow next year. But you don't want to put those in the soil anyway because they're adulterated.
Right, right.
They are
they'll
not.
Leach and they'll...
They're not the way. They're a hybrid. They're treated. And you know, in the seed, you stop and think about the seed. The seed is where all the enzymes and the life force is at, you know, in order to make that plant.
Right.
And you have to start with a good foundation, just like you have to build and strengthen the foundation of your body.
Right, right.
You know, and you only get one body. You know, you better take care of it because, you know, if you think there's an answer to your problem out there, I got news for you. It's not going to be pretty for the most part, you know, that you're going to go through. So there's a time and a place for medicine, but I'm going to tell you, there's a lot of things that you can take care of and then use allopathic in the event that you need it. You know, if, and I've said this before, you know, you get in a car accident, you know, well, hey, you know, I did, but thank God we were, everybody was okay when my westbound caddy hit that southbound Nebraska corn-fed buck. It was a monster. And, you know, so that's GMO food. All those cornfields out there, it's all, you know, Monsanto genetically modified corn. So, yeah, that's not good. But I don't know what I was going to say there about that. I guess I got a little too far sidetracked here. So back to the aloe vera juice here. You know, there's been studies on aloe for its immune stimulating activity. And then more studies on it as a method of overcoming Candida albicans. You know, a lot of times you can have Candida so out of control, that fungus internally, that you get a rash on your skin or a rash over the areas that are being affected when it spills out of through leaky gut syndrome and makes it into the abdominal cavity and spreads through there. A lot of brain fog and stuff can happen when it's in the bloodstream and makes its way, you know, past the blood-brain barrier and makes its way into the brain, makes its way into the central nervous system. So aloe vera juice or the concentrate 1 ounce a day is one way to kill that candida in the body. And, I mean, it's going to give you a good cleansing out through the gastrointestinal tract. That's for sure. And it will clean you out. But what it does is it will kill that candida, the fungus. And, you know, a lot of that is it's triggered by sugar and a lot of stress, antibiotic treatment. So Europe has done studies as well on aloe, and their studies indicate that it has the ability to help lower blood sugar levels in diabetics. And experimental research conducted at the University of Texas Medical School at Houston may prove aloe vera to be beneficial in the fight against AIDS. So it's certainly something that is beneficial to add that into any type of herbal program or natural regime that you're doing with any immune system problems. So aloe vera juice helps improve reactions to allergies by enhancing the removal of allergens and toxins from the body. Aloe vera contains a rich supply of polysaccharides, and that's a source of mucilagin that absorbs toxins in through the digestive tract and in the bloodstream, and it helps to reduce, you know, bowel transit time. Aloe also contains a variety of different properties that can be strongly laxative in nature. So you don't want to exceed 1 ounce a day. You could take the aloe vera capsules. One capsule of our aloe vera is equal to 1 ounce. It's dehydrated, and it's equal to 1 ounce of aloe. So that's a bottle of 100. So for the cost of that, one a day is all that's needed on the aloe vera capsules, and you can just do one a day. That is 100 days worth. So it's definitely a good thing if your kids can swallow capsules. Everybody just takes one of them in the morning. It's also used, it stimulates bile secretion and peristaltic action. That's the squeezing and moving effect that the bowel does. And you do not ever take aloe vera capsules or the aloe vera juice or concentrate. You never take aloe vera internally during pregnancy. Never.
Okay.
That is not, never, ever, do not. And it's because of that peristaltic action that it triggers. If you go into labor, those contractions, that's peristaltic action. That's squeezing and relaxing and squeezing and relaxing, that peristaltic action. And the uterus is triggered by peristaltic. Okay, so peristaltic action. So you never want to do that because you could go into early labor. So you need to remember that it is it's strong laxative as well. So no more than an ounce a day if you're drinking it. The substances stimulate the cleansing. So cleansing of the digestive tract. So make sure that 8 to 12 hours, excuse me, 8 to 12 hours following ingestion that you're close by somewhere as far as the bathroom goes. Aloe vera supplies so many nutrients. There's over 200 nutritional properties in aloe vera that make
wow.
that up. But some of the nutrients that we find in there from a mineral standpoint is calcium and iron. It's a really good source of magnesium and manganese. It's also high in potassium and natural occurring sodium, zinc, as well as lecithin. So, you know, with sodium, you know, we've always been told all of this, you know, no salt, no salt, no salt, no salt. And, you know, salt, sodium is the catalyst. That's the spark within the cell. And it's true that you don't want to have an excess of sodium in your diet, but we have to have sodium in our diet.
Right.
And there's a balance within the cell of the sodium and potassium. So, like, I really love the herb dandelion for balancing the sodium-potassium level in the cell. Aloe vera will also do that because of the properties of potassium and sodium that are found inherently in the aloe vera. So what happens when people are really dehydrated or people are sick and you do make it to the ER and they admit you? You know, what's one of the first IVs they put in you? You
saline.
Know, the saline.
Yeah.
And that's salt. There's sodium there. And everything starts perking up and you start feeling
right.
better. So it's true, we don't want an excess of salt. You know, we do need sodium. And there's a product that I really, really like that I've used for years with cooking. And it's made by a manufacturer, a company called Gaylord Housen. And the name of the product is Vegicell. And they're also the company that make Spike. I personally don't care too much for Spike, but the Vegicell I've used for 35 years. It has sea salt, but a lot of the salt that I use from a salt standpoint is the pink Himalayan salt that has 85 different minerals and trace minerals in that. I mean, that's the standard salt that I use in my home. And with cooking, I'll use a little bit of that, and then I use the Vegicell. And the Vegicell has sea salt, but then it has dehydrated, quite a few dehydrated vegetables and herbs that are mixed in that. And it's kind of greenish colored. And I use that in so many things because what it is it's a natural biochemical sodium that the body needs. It's not like the table salt, traditional table salt that they've thrown some iodine back into, which is not enough iodine anyway to take care of feeding the thyroid. But there's more properties in that Vegicel. And if you're in the Denver area, you know, the health food stores carry it. King Supers always carries it. And if you, you know, live somewhere that does not have that product in the spice aisle, go, you know, go up to the customer service. Ask them to order it in. It's Gaylord Housen. And a lot of people, yeah, I think they're more familiar with the spike, but they make that product, the Vegicel. And you'll really, really, really like that. Aloe vera is also excellent to be massaged into the hair and the scalp. So it helps to take care of eczema or psoriasis in the scalp. And historically, it's always been said that by massaging that into the scalp, it increases hair growth and improves its overall condition. So aloe is something that summertime, and it's really important that you realize that it's this time of the year that you're going for aloe more than any other time of the year. So I really would encourage you to, you know, order some of that and know that what you're getting is pure aloe vera. It's free of any kind of contaminants, and there's no food dyes in it, because you don't want to put, and I've done a show, go back, look at those. I went through all of the food dyes and how horrible they were and the exposure to them, what they have been linked to, and that's in a past show. And one thing I want to say here before the end of this show is lemons. You know, get plenty of lemons. Lemons are a great way to keep your pH in balance. It's an extremely high alkaline fruit. It's acid in its natural state, but it's alkaline in the body. And I'm always telling people to, you know, drink lemon water, or in the morning, if you want a good cleanse to take care of all that metabolic breakdown during the middle of the night, and a gentle cleanse for the whole digestive tract, and especially the liver, to detoxify the liver from everything that of its 500 functions that it's been struggling to try to do, also with breaking down all of those toxins and stuff. Hot lemon water, a couple cups of hot lemon water in the morning, I like two or three of them. And you just put this, squeeze a half of a lemon into each cup of hot water. And I use the high alkaline water. And if you go to Kingdom of Healing on Facebook, the telephone number is there on the page for the alkaline water unit and the air purifier. And you can get a hold of Greg, and the telephone number is there. And if you've not visited the page, be sure to like the page. That would be great. But I want to go through real quick some of the benefits. You know, you hear so much about, oh, drink lemon water. And you know, this is why. You know, naturally occurring, lemon is an extremely high antioxidant. It also has, you know, a protein. It contains the B complex and vitamin C. It has bioflavonoids that are present. It's high in potassium. And it's widely known for its antiviral immune building capabilities. So, you know, if you're dealing with the leaky gut syndrome, or any kind of intestinal problems, by drinking that hot lemon water in the morning and then following maybe with an ounce of the whole leaf aloe vera. And if you're rebuilding a digestive tract that has had a lot of antibiotics introduced and you know, you're sensitive to wheat and gluten products, and you've got either leaky gut or you suspect that with a lot of bloating and stuff, this is very good for cleansing and cleaning that area, getting the aloe in to facilitate and proliferate building a new cells, and then follow with some of those drinks that we've got that you can find on Kingdom of Healing. They're delicious. The Love and Peas, and the Nature's Harvest is a green drink that is phenomenal. I'm not kidding you. It is phenomenal. There's not a green drink out there that tastes as good as that Nature's Harvest. And it's just an incredible product. I'm going to tell you, you'll be addicted to it. You will be craving it. And you'll feel so good after you drink it. You'll go, geez, I didn't miss that meal. I want to drink some more of that stuff. It's outstanding. So lemons help to balance the pH. Another thing, drinking lemon water helps to metabolize the acidic waste in your body, and it helps to prevent acne. It also helps with regulating blood sugar. So the drink helps you to maintain more of an average healthy weight. There's also pectin that's found in lemons, and that pectin can also help with staving off any cravings that you have. So lemon water is a good way to prevent, feeling hungry all the time. Kidney stones. The potassium in lemons help to increase the citrate in the urine, and this prevents the oxalate from forming as far as kidney stones, meaning that it flushes out the kidney stones. Lemon water has also been known to support the lymphatic system, and it works in conjunction with the immune system. That's where our gut and our lymphatic system is, our immune system. It helps with flushing and cleansing out the gallbladder if you've got a lot of discomfort under your right rib cage or the solar plex, or you're having some pains that's running from the, right shoulder blade up to the left rotator cuff. It's a good sign that you've got some gallstones there. Lemon water is an excellent way to help to flush and clean that out. If they're cholesterol stones, those dissolve down and you move those out really well. If they're calcium stones, then it's best to use lemon water with unfiltered apple juice, a glass of unfiltered apple juice, and squeeze half of a lemon in that, and pretty much go on a fast of that for 3 to 4 days.
Wow.
Yeah, and you can add the products, gallbladder formula, that you can find on kingdomofhealing.com, gallbladder formula, and hydrangea. And hydrangea breaks those stones down, the calcium stones, so that you can pass them. And then after 4 or 5 days of doing that, you can add a quarter of a cup of olive oil to about 6 ounces of apple juice, unfiltered apple juice, with a half of a lemon squeezed in that, and drink that. And wow, you will pass a lot of gallstones by morning. I promise you, you will. Colds and flus, lemons extremely high in vitamin C. They have antiviral properties and antibacterial as well. They're an excellent remedy for colds and flu. You do the lemon with a little apple cider vinegar and a tiny bit of honey, and that's very, very good for colds and flus, sore throats. Gastroesophageal reflux disease, GERDs. Lemon water can be used to replace Tums. If you've got a lot of spots on your fingernails, soak your fingers in your hands in some lemon water. Foodborne illnesses, lemon water is great for bringing up the natural acids in the stomach for digestion. And it's excellent to prevent food poisoning. Fibromyalgia, people dealing with the exhaustion and the pain from fibromyalgia, it's really important to drink lemon water and flush those toxins that trigger the inflammation in the body, and flush those out of the body. So lemon water is excellent. Lemons have an anti-inflammatory property, so therefore they can help to neutralize that acidic condition. And it's really, really good because the acidity is the leading cause of inflammation in tissue. So sugar and a lot of that cause the inflammation. Muscle soreness, joint swelling and pain, you know, it's all of its anti-inflammatory properties. Alcohol cravings, you know, next time you go to a party and you're the designated dry burn, as much as you want to drink, have a drink or two, start drinking lemon water. You won't have a craving to, you know, indulge in one or two drinks. Colitis, Crohn's disease, it helps with the imbalance of the acid alkaline levels in the body. So again, you know, lemons, it's just a great way to bring that pH level up. It's really a very simple health product that is extremely beneficial. So make sure that you're buying the organic lemons. And my brother in California has this awesome lemon tree with just hundreds and hundreds of organic lemons on it. And it's like, wow. I wish I had a case of them every couple months. So anyway, that is all for today's show. And I want to thank you for joining me today. And you have a great week and be safe. And I'll be back next week. Have a great day.